Hi, Venu. I hope you can hear me loud and clear. Please confirm me on the chat window. And as I believe that you have told Nisha that you will join from next batch, is it? Hi Radhika. Hi Anirban, welcome to the session. How have you been, guys? Guys, let's just wait for another 2 to 3 minutes and then we shall start the session, right? I'll just start sharing my screen in a while. Shivam was there, Radhika, but I can't see him now. He must have logged out, even Anirban. So Radhika, we are going to start fresh, okay? This is your first session of digital marketing. And so the sessions that you have been attending, that was just the additional part, okay? So just don't concentrate on those sessions. Just start as a fresh, okay? Because all those topics we are going to cover in this session again, okay? Okay, guys, great. Yes, Radhika, you can attend that classes also, not a problem. No, it's absolutely up to you, Radhika. You can continue with this and the other one as well. Okay, Vinu, not a problem. You can start from today onwards. You can start the June batch. Okay. Hi, Shivam. Welcome to the session. Hi, Anirban. Welcome to the session, guys. I'm just starting sharing my screen now. Please confirm whether you all can see my screen or not. I hope my voice is clear. Great. Okay, guys. So let's just begin with the first class today. So guys, as I told you that in my first segment, I hope every one of you have attended my demo class, right? The demo session. Is there any doubt from the demo class, guys? Anirban, Radhika, Shivam, Vinu, is there any doubt from the demo class, guys? No, okay, great. So I would want a quick response from each one of you because the sessions would really be interactive, okay? So try to communicate, interact as much as you can and raise questions as it comes to your mind, okay? I will address the same right away. Moving ahead, guys. So as I told you in my segment one, we are going to start with segment one, which is WordPress, guys, WordPress. That is website designing. Hope you guys remember. Yes. Okay, so as I know, Radhika has her own website. How about others? Vinu, Shivam, Anirban, do you guys know what is WordPress? Do you guys have your own website? Have you guys tried creating your website? Shivam says yes. How about others? Anirban, Vinu, I don't have, okay, but you know what is WordPress, right, Vinu? Anirban is logged out, not a problem. Okay, so guys, Shivam, you have a WordPress website, is it? Yes, okay, great. So you want, so you guys want me to start with the WordPress only, or we just switch over to other segment? Because here I'm going to cover how you purchase the domain from the GoDaddy, then how you link your domain with hosting. SEO, okay. Shivam says begin with SEO only, okay. I want reviews from each one of you. Radhika, what do you suggest? Okay. Okay, guys. So I can just quickly tell you how you can buy the domain and all. Okay, Venu says start from the WordPress. Okay. So guys, I'm starting from the very beginning, which is WordPress website. To have a website, guys, you need a domain and hosting, which I've told you in my demo class also, right? So guys, domain is the web address, okay? Which is the URL of your website. Hosting is the space on the web world. Internet, or you can say web world. So guys, domain, as you know, it is like this, dnpathshala.com. So guys, this is the domain, okay? The web address or URL, and it always be unique. Then this .com, guys, as you see this extension .com, this is called TLD, guys, which is top level domain. This is called TLD, which is top level domain. Okay, the extension part, and these can be of two types, guys. One is generic and the other one is regional based, region. Okay, within generic, guys, you have options like .com, .net. These are all generic. .online, .org, .gov. These are all generic. These TLDs are called generic TLDs. And then you have regional based TLDs, guys, which is .in, .us, .uk, which is for United Kingdom, .ca for Canada, .au for Australia, right? .in for India, as you guys must be aware of. So these are called TLDs, guys, okay? The first priority of everyone is .com, because that is mostly used and worldwide, and people are well versed with .com only. Yes, we know. I'm going to share the Word document. Okay. So everyone tries to first look for .com, then probably region wise. So guys, if your business or your website is, like, if your business is registered in a particular country, so let's say in Canada, if you have a company registered in Canada, only then you can have this domain. Earlier, there were not such conditions, right? But now government has imposed such conditions. So now this company, which is geocreations.ch, is registered in Canada. That's the reason we have got this domain. This is our own company, guys. We have this company, Your Creation, started by my husband only. And here we help our clients in digital marketing services. Okay. So that is called TLD, guys. Then hosting, which is space on the web world. So guys, as you might be aware, because some of you have got the domain or have the website already. So guys, you can buy from GoDaddy, the most famous one. BigRock is the other one. There are many other websites which are available through which you can buy the domain, but these are the most used or famous one for the website domains. Okay, then guys, for hosting, you can either go from GoDaddy only, or you can go for HostGator, guys. HostGator. Okay. So guys, if you are buying domain and hosting from one vendor, which is, let's say, from GoDaddy only, in that case, you don't need to link both, right? Whereas if you are buying domain from different vendor and hosting from different vendor, in that case, you need to link the both. So let's say if you buy hosting or space, let's say domain from GoDaddy, but hosting from HostGator. Okay, you buy hosting from HostGator and domain from GoDaddy. So these both are different vendors, guys. So if you buy from different vendors, in that case, you have to link the both, guys. You have to link it both. Okay, make sense, guys? Any doubt till now? Any doubt, guys? No, okay, great. So how can you link that? There is a name server called, which you are going to get from GoDaddy, which you have to mention, sorry, which you will get from HostGator, and you have to mention with it GoDaddy. So I'll just show you how you can change. Radhika, I think yours is open. Is it? So I can show you from here only. But how come it's not showing? I think my domains have got expired. I think I don't have any domain right now to showcase. Okay, sure. Let me just sign it out. Okay, I'll just give you the remote control, Radhika. Can you sign in now? Radhika, I hope you are entering the credentials. Okay, great guys, thank you so much. So here I'm gonna come and see the domain, existing domain. So I'll just select the domain setting. Oh, sorry, manage DNS. So guys, what will happen when you buy hosting from HostGator, guys? So HostGator will send you an email with following details, okay? Email with following details, which will include, guys, one is the login credentials for your cPanel, which is control panel, guys. Okay, I'm going to showcase this, and also name server details, guys. So as I told you, that if you have domain from different vendor and hosting from different vendor, in that case you are going to use this name server details to link the both. Okay, so guys, here you're gonna come on the, when you click on a particular domain, click on manage DNS, scroll down, here you get to see name server, guys. Name server. Okay, so if you are buying both the things from GoDaddy, let's say you're buying a domain and hosting from GoDaddy, in that case you don't need to change these details. But if the hosting is different, then you have to mention the name server details, which you will get in your email. Okay, make sense, guys? Any doubt? So here you just click on change and then enter your name server details. You just copy and paste it, right? Guys, clear? Anirban, Radhika, Shivam, Vinu? Yes, okay. Internet is very slow at your place. Can you use your 3G? Anirban, can you use phone internet? You can get your phone recharge, internet recharge basically. And use the hotspot. I believe that should help you. Anyways, Anirban, you can also look my recordings also at later stage if you are having problem right now. Later on, you can view this recording and that will help you. Clear, guys? So let me just open one document. So guys, you are to create a WordPress based website, you will first buy the domain from GoDaddy, let's say, and that will be renewed annually, guys. Okay, you will pay annually for that website, for that domain, and even for hosting. And let's say you're buying hosting from HostGator, then also you will pay annually. Okay, hosting provider will give you username and password of your cPanel, guys, control panel. And also they will provide you name server details of your hosting server. Okay, so you are going to receive the login credentials, as I told you, the username and password of your control panel, where you are going to install WordPress. Okay, and also they are going to provide you name server details, which you are going to enter in GoDaddy domain manage DNS. Okay, so you have to connect hosting and domain. You will have to copy the name server details which your hosting provider will give you and then paste it in the name server settings of your domain, guys, right? This we have just covered. And as I showed you, name server details you can change, edit, and then save it. So now here, guys, you can see the control panel. So I'll just show you for one of my accounts. So you are going to have the website domain and then cPanel, guys. This you are going to receive from the hosting services. Login, use your login credentials that you have received in your email, guys. Okay, now scroll down. Scroll down, guys. Come to software. Can you see software, guys? Click on quick install. cPanel is the backend control panel where you are going to install your WordPress, okay? Any content management system, guys. WordPress is what? WordPress is the content management system, guys. Content management system, which is CMS, that helps you to build the website without any coding. Okay, so you have other CMS systems also which are available, like Joomla, guys. You have OpenCart, you have Magento. These are other, like Wix. These are other content management systems which really helps you to create the website. Okay, so you are going to go into cPanel, which is your control panel, okay, from where you get, you have a control of your hosting, of your server, Venu, basically. Is it clear? And here you are going to install WordPress. You can select others also, like Drupal, Joomla, Magento, but here in DMP we are covering WordPress because that is mostly used and it is quite convenient and user-friendly websites which you can create, and mostly nowadays people using WordPress. So you are going to click on install WordPress, guys. Okay, so as it is already installed in my website, so I'm not gonna click here install WordPress. So when you install WordPress, guys, after installing WordPress, so guys, after installing WordPress, you are going to have the login credentials for your WordPress website. Okay, and then this is how you can log into your WordPress website, guys. This, the URL will remain standard, like you are going to have the domain name and /wp-admin. This will remain common for all the websites, okay, which are built on WordPress. So this is how you can click on WP, like WordPress backend. This will be your website backend where you are going to make changes. So guys, once you have installed WordPress, after installing WordPress, you are going to get the credentials for your WordPress website. Then you will open your WordPress credentials, like you will enter your WordPress credentials here, guys, in this email. Make sense in this login page. Is it clear, guys? Let me just open now my document. I'm just looking for my password, guys. Give me a second, guys. Let me just look for the password. Okay, I can use yours in that case, Radhika. Okay, can you okay, let me just put your use the control, you have the control. Okay, just wait. Okay, please go ahead, Radhika. I hope now it's okay. Okay guys, so this is how it will look, your WordPress backend, your website backend will look like this. This is the dashboard that you will logged into, okay? So guys, the first and the foremost thing is that you have to upload the theme, okay? So you go to appearance and then click on themes, guys. Go to appearance and click on themes, guys. So guys, as we told you already, so guys, you have to log in to your WordPress, then go to appearance. And then themes. So guys, you can select your theme from themify.me. Okay, we are going to give you paid theme from themify.me, which you can select based on your website theme, right? Or based on your product or services that you are going to offer. So guys, there are many free templates. Nothing is coming. Okay, is it for everyone? You're not seeing my screen, guys? Or only Shivam is facing that problem? Anirban, Radhika, we know I can, it's visible. It's visible to everyone, Shivam. Please check at your end. So guys, you have to first select appearance and then theme, right? There are many free templates also available which you can use, but guys, those templates doesn't allow you or give you all the functionalities, right? Whereas the paid theme gives you mostly all the functionalities. Shivam, I think there's a problem at your end. Please get it fixed, or you can close the screen and then rejoin. So guys, from here you can add new theme. Okay, and then click on upload theme. You can upload the theme now. So guys, when you click on upload theme, you can choose the file, okay? And then you can install here. Shivam, is it fixed now? Right guys, so once your theme is uploaded, let me just come back. Then you wanna go on customize. Radhika, is it a paid theme or free template that you are using? Okay. So guys, you wanna come here on customize, and from here you can edit your website. Okay, you can change the layout, change the colors, font. It becomes very easy now to change your or the details of your website. It looks good, Radhika. Yes, that's the reason we suggest only paid themes. In that case you don't face such issues. It's problem with the free themes or free templates. Guys, you can create pages, different pages. So as these are the pages which are created by Radhika for her website, you can edit. So let's say edit projects. So you have not provided much details here, Radhika. Yeah, I can see that. So guys, to add any picture, images here, you can click on add media. And from, as you can see here, this is the media library which is created. You can create your library, you can upload your files here. Okay. And then you can select the image. I'm not gonna do right now because this website is live. So guys, this topic, like how you can edit your website, we're gonna do when. So guys, I want each one of you to select the domain for your website. And hosting we are going to provide you, and theme. Okay, so select the domain for your website because we want you guys to practice, and we are going to give you free of cost. So guys, what you can do is you can buy a domain at your end, and we are going to refund you that money. Okay, theme we are going to upload on your WordPress. Okay, the paid theme, guys, the paid theme. So you have to select theme from themify.me and let us know that this theme you have finalized and you want this theme for your website. So we are going to give you that particular theme. Okay, and guys, you don't need to buy hosting. We are going to buy hosting. We are going to give you the hosting as well. Make sense, guys? Yes. Okay. So you want me to check features? Okay. Theme, we have the theme themify.me. This is the URL from where you can look for the themes for your website, Vinu. It's gonna free. We are going to give you free, so don't worry about the pricing part. It's worth rupees 3,000. Guys, one theme worth rupees 3,000, guys. No, I'm not using, Radhika. I'm not using, don't worry. I'm just showcasing this to Vinu. I'm on different website, themify.me. Yes, these are all paid themes. These are all paid themes which we are going to give you free because we have got these themes with us. We have already purchased all the themes and we are going to give free of cost, okay, to our students. Because we want each one of you to practice. Okay. However, Radhika, you can look for different domain for your website and select the theme from here. And the theme is worth rupees 3,000, guys. Okay. Amenities is. Guys, please keep yourself on mute. There are many themes available. You can select from there itself. You can see here. So you can see in themify.me, there are different topics like Themify, Shopee, Ultra, Peak, Music, Parallax, Split, Landing. And when you click on, let's say, further Ultra, there you get further segregation or categorizations of theme like here. You can select whether your website is agency-based, restaurant, wedding, spa, lawyer, e-commerce website. So you can select from here within this also. Okay. Within each, there are number of themes available. Okay. Yeah. Clear, guys? Great. So guys, I'm coming back to my document here, which I've told you about the name server, then control panel, guys. You are going to go within control panel, click on software, you just scroll down to software, click on quick install, then you are going to get this install WordPress button. Click on install WordPress. Install WordPress, guys, and then you are going to land on this dashboard. This is the back end of your website, guys. Okay, and we are going to give you one paid theme from themify.me. So then after which we are going to upload the theme, guys. So as I told you, showcase you already, like you are going to go into appearance and then click on theme, sorry, themes. Click on themes and then click on add new and then say upload. Okay, simple, guys. So once you upload your theme, then you can simple make edit. Simply, you can just edit the content and the images of your website. Make sense? Any doubt? So guys, I would first want you to do all these steps first. First buy the domain for your website for which we are going to refund the money. Okay. And then let us know the domain and the theme. We are going to upload the theme on your domain and then you just practice on the WordPress. Okay. And here I can showcase you how you can make changes, right, to your website. Make sense, guys? Domain, we will give you only the 99 rupees domain, guys. How you can buy domain, guys? Please use the incognito window. Go to Chrome and click here on these three dots, then click on new incognito window, guys. Open here. I would suggest you to open here and go to Google because in this incognito window, the cookies are not safe. Okay, so you are going to get the best price. Click on GoDaddy from here, and this ad you are going to see. Ad, click here on this ad, and now you can look for the domain here. Vinu, do you have any domain in mind? any domain guys which you want me to look for now? Handcrafts.com. That must be already taken. Tough one. See, handcrafts.com is already taken. So what you can go for, handcraftspro.com, handcraftsnow.com, hub.com, handcraftsfit.com. So these are the available ones in relation to your domain, Vinu. Okay. And when you're going to go into incognito window, you are going to see the best price, guys. Okay. That will also be taken. Handcraft.com, I believe that should help. So, guys, you can search this domain in your sweet time. So, these are the available. This is how you can look for, guys, actually. Okay. So, once you decide upon the domain, I'll share the contact number of a person of my colleague who will let you know, okay? Who will refund your money back, okay? Her name is Srishti, guys, Srishti. Please, I'm just giving you her number. Contact her for domain and theme, guys. Please let her know which theme you want. I'm just sharing her contact here. So there should you go. Okay, I'll email you guys across, don't worry. Okay, I'll send in the group, guys. Sure, Radhika. And guys, how do you do the SEO of your website, which is created on WordPress? For that, you have to go to plugins. There is a plugin which is available by the name of SEO Yoast. SEO of WordPress based website. That is by SEO Yoast. Okay. So SEO Yoast plugin will be used for doing SEO of the WordPress based website. So guys, you have to look for the plugin. Just click on the plugin, click on add new. Radhika, have you installed? Okay. SEO Yoast, guys. This is the plugin for doing SEO of your website. You want me to install now, Radhika? Okay, so guys, you can see here, Yoast SEO, click here on install now. So guys, once you click on install, now you see activate. Click here on activate. Okay, so now your SEO has been installed. Can you see this SEO option is coming here? So guys, you can do SEO of your website now. So guys, can you see now, Radhika, and you can relate now. Plugin for WordPress like SEO Yoast, you're talking about Shivam. Find SEO Yoast. Radhika, can you see now here? The panel for SEO Yoast, SEO has been added. Okay, and now we can do the SEO of your website. Okay. Make sense, guys? Any doubt till now? Are the things getting clear? Radhika, Shivam, Vinu? Yes, okay. Great. So, guys, this is how you can have SEO on your WordPress website, but now we have to first cover SEO before you begin with the SEO part, guys, right? I'm going to share this document with you guys, which has the details which we have just covered, WordPress based website. Okay. Have you find Shivam now? No search result is coming. Is your internet working fine? So guys, this is how your SEO Yoast will be added, like the panel will be added for your SEO Yoast. And this, you can see the complete analysis also of this particular page. Can you see? Yes. And this is how it is visible. And when you click on edit, I'm going to cover this SEO title, slug and meta description, guys. I'm going to cover this. These are the part of your SEO website, like on page. Shivam, I believe in that case you have to share your screen with me. I'll just make you the co-host. Okay, please share your screen with me. So now you will get an option to share the screen. Can you please share your screen with me, Shivam, so that I can check? Shivam, are you sharing the screen? Okay, so you are here. Please scroll down, scroll down. Okay, scroll up, sorry, scroll up. You are into plugins, right? Add new. Right, now go to search bar, search bar. Yes, type in here SEO Yoast. Yes, no plugins match your request. How come you're getting this? How come you're getting this option? Can you type author name? Team Yoast? You are not getting even Google Analytics. Have you bought this domain or you have directly created this with WordPress? This domain you have got from GoDaddy or you have bought the WordPress website, but that will not make any difference. From Big Rock, okay, got you. But that will not make any difference basically. Can you change this drop-down keyword? Click on keyword and now type author and type team Yoast. Team Yoast. Yes. No plugins. Because I can see like even okay, let me just take that up separately. Shivam, I'll take that up separately, okay? Okay, guys, coming back. And I hope you have received my email also, Shivam. Have you received my email I have sent you? So Vasu, you have entered this or no? This is suggested. Okay. Sorry. So guys, here I was showing you the complete analysis of the web page that is suggested by after entering the SEO Yoast. Okay, here. And when you click here on the snippet, these are the tags, guys, SEO tags. SEO title tag, meta description tag, focus keyword tag. These are all tags that we are going to cover in the SEO session. Okay. Guys, now I believe you can do this much, till this much, where you can just look for the domain and let us know about the details of your domain, and we are going to, and also the theme, guys, after finalizing your theme, right? And then uploading the theme, guys, right? And then making some changes to your website. Clear, guys? So when I'm going to do the SEO, I'm going to cover all these things where how, what is headline, paragraph, guys, these are all will be covered in within the SEO. It's not coming now. Radhika, this page is not coming, right? There you go. So guys, this will be covered like heading one, heading two. These are all part of SEO and these things help you in SEO also. Okay. Clear, guys? So now I'll just quickly brief you, like search engine optimization, SEO, which is also called organic listing, natural listing, and unpaid listing. I hope you guys remember, when you Google and let's say I type my query, which is why iPhone 7, this is my query. It's query, search query for me, but the people who are working on this query, that will become keyword for them. It will become keyword for them, guys. So guys, all these listings where no ad option is written, okay? These are part of search engine optimization and they come through organic listing, okay? So guys, there can be total maximum 10 listing of SEO in per page, 10 listing of SEO per page, which is search engine RP. SERP, which is search engine result page, you are going to see 10 listings of SEO per page, guys, okay? After which, so how your website is going to rank here on Google? What activities you need to do as part of SEO, guys? So SEO can be done in two ways, guys. Two ways. One is on page and the other is off page. Have you guys ever heard of these terminologies? On page and off page, guys. Radhika says yes. Okay. Meenu says no. Okay, not a problem. On page, guys, all the activities that you are going to perform on your website. So, guys, on page is all the activities that you are going to perform on your website to make it relevant, guys. This word is very important, that is relevant. You have to make your website relevant, guys. The other name for on page is the relevancy. Okay, if your website is not relevant, then Google will not rank your website on its search engine result page. So you have to make sure that the website that you're working on, the information you provide has to be very relevant. And you have to make sure that you write content, keeping two things in mind, guys. Two things, major things you have to keep in mind. One is the SEO and not SEO, sorry, the search engine. Search engine, guys. And the other is users. So, guys, you have to make sure that you write for both of these parties. One for search engine and the other for users. If you ignore one party, let's say if you ignore users and you keep on writing the content, keeping search engine in mind, then your information will not be valid and it will not stay long for longer period on Google search engine result page. And even users will not gonna stay on your website. Our end objective is to reach to our target audience, right? That is the reason if users are not going to stay on a website, then there will be not a point of doing SEO. So guys, you have to make sure that you write the content for your search engine and users. Both, right? So earlier what people used to do, they just write the content keeping search engine in mind. They just write all the keywords in the web pages, okay? And when user used to visit their website, they were not happy, they were not finding the relevant results. So what Google has done, they have made sure that you write content for users as well. Okay, is it clear, guys? Making sense? Radhika, Shivam, Veenu? Yes, okay, great. Okay. So you have to write the content for both search engine and users. And that's the reason it's called relevancy, guys. On page is also called relevancy, whereas off page is popularity. It's called popularity. One thing is, guys, making your thing, what you are selling, the website through which you are selling has to be relevant. Other thing is the popularity. You have to be popular. If you are in the industry, you have to be popular so that people know. If people know about you, Google will really appreciate that part. This is also called, guys, link building, like building relationship, guys. Okay. Off-page popularity or link building. These are all one and the same thing. My voice is breaking, is it? Just a second, guys. Is it clear now? Okay, great. So guys, off-page popularity and link building is one and the same thing. Link building means you have to make relationship with other websites also, okay? And you have to become popular. Only then Google will rank your website. So let's say here, for example, website you have, website A is your website, okay? Your website name is A, that is www.a.com. And there is another website by the name of website B. Okay, and let's say website B is mentioning within its own website about website A.com, and there is another website which is website C, and website C is also mentioning about website A.com within its website. Okay, so now you can see that A.com, let's say website A is getting popular because even website B is mentioning about website A and website C is also mentioning about website A, right? And website A is building relation or building links with website B and C. Clear? Making sense, guys? No, Radhika says no. Okay, confused. Shivam says yes. Guys, try to understand here, okay? Off-page is, guys, making your website popular, okay? How you will make your website popular? When other websites will talk about your website? Make sense? Right? Your website will only popular when other websites will talk about you. Okay? How a person will become famous? A person will become famous if other people are all talking about that particular person. If we take an example of a prime minister, which is Narendra Modi, how he has become famous because each and every person is talking about him, right? So he has become famous. Similarly, in the online world also, if you want to make your website famous, so you have to make sure that other websites should also talk about your website. So if they mention about your website, so here for an example, website B is mentioning about website A, and website C is mentioning about website A, that means website A is getting famous, getting popular because these websites are mentioning about website A. And link building, how the link is happening, because website A is building relationship with website B and C. Make sense now? Radhika, Venu, Shivam, getting clear now? Understood, great. Okay, Venu is also happy with now. Great, guys. So this is called link building, where you build relationship. The other names for off-page is popularity. Here, guys, you don't do any activity on your website. It's like that's the reason it's called off page, because you are not going to do anything on your website. Here you want links from people from other website. It's not in your control. Now on page, guys, it's in your hand, it's in your control how you can make your website relevant, but here how you can make your website popular, it's not much in your control. However, there are things that you can do at your end, but that will not count much. Okay, so guys, so you have to make sure that you get more links from different website in order to get famous. Okay, but that is not in your control. That really depends whether people will give you links or not. Make sense? Is it clear now, guys, the difference between on page and off page? Exactly, Shivam. There are different ways how you can create relationship that I can talk, that I'm gonna talk when we do off page. Okay, yes. So guys, this is about on page and off page. And in off page, guys, I want to tell you one more important point. Social media marketing is done for off page. Social media marketing, as in, I didn't understand your question, Radhika. Yeah, I got FB, yeah, Facebook. Yes. No, that is not part of off page. That is not part of SEO. There you can submit your links. Yes. You can submit your links of your website to make your website popular. Exactly. Yeah, Insta, LinkedIn, these are the other ways, guys. There are many other ways also. You can use blogs, you can write articles, you can write, you can submit on social bookmarking. I'm going to cover all these points in my off-page session, guys, when we are going to do off-page, okay? All these will be covered there. So don't worry right now. So guys, now I was about to tell you one more important point in off-page, guys. When you get a link from any other website, you have to make sure that you get a quality link, guys, right? So the links will depend on two parameters, the number of links that you are getting. Second, the quality of links, right? So you have to make sure the numbers will only not matter, guys. Numbers will not only matter. Quality will also matter, guys. Quality of links has to be, you know, very much important. Why? Because earlier, Google just used to consider the number of links, not the quality of links. But in that case, there was no relevancy. There was no relation. So now quality of link has been introduced long back time. Okay. So this has made SEO more powerful. Okay. Does Trivago justify off page? As in? Trivago provide links to other hotel websites. See, that is one way of doing business. They are doing business, Radhika, because Trivago is charging for that. Okay. What Trivago is doing, Trivago is getting commission. That is affiliate kind of marketing. Okay. Trivago will not be count for this link building, basically. Clear. So guys, quality of links will also matter here, as I was telling you. So let's say how the quality can be maintained. Guys, you have to make sure the link that you are getting has to be from the related website. Okay, so let's say you are into sports business, sportsaccessories.com. You have a website called sportsaccessories.com. Okay, this is your website. And if you get a link in educational website, you can see that educational website is not much related. Radhika, okay, you are talking about when we search on Google, the number one website shown is by 99acres.com. You are asking me like how they show the number one website on 99acres? Then? Yeah, okay, you are asking like when you do in 99acres, when you search, you get to see Vasu infrastructure there. Vasu infrastructure ad, you are running an ad campaign. Display campaign. Yeah, in that case, you have to create display ad for 99acre website. Are you clear, Radhika? If you see, don't confuse yourself with SEO and the ad campaign. These are both different terminologies, right? For ad, for running an ad, we pay to Google, okay? And SEO is free. We don't pay anything to Google, right? And if you want to run the ad campaign, you have to create the display ad campaign. Let me just open 99acre for you so that you can explain. Okay, open Google. Okay, let me just open Google. Okay, yes, now 99acre. Yes. Within 99acres? No. Okay. Hair only? Okay. There I can see. Yes. This one? Yes. See, on the exact name, see, you are getting your result on the exact same name, right? So Google, if companies who don't do SEO, right, even they get to see here. Wait, I don't believe that you have done the SEO, right, for your website. So it searched by the exact name, right? So key search keywords are basically like this. So someone looking for real estate in Rajnagar extension, for example. Now, can you see now coming your website anywhere? Okay. So it has just matched the exact name actually of your website. So any company like who is not doing the SEO. So if I take any website, I have no idea of any other website. So let's say Preeti Bartla. So here you can see Facebook is showing my profile, Preeti Bartla, Twitter. So wherever my name is mentioned, you can see my this coming. Right, because it has matched the exact name. Okay. So the point is getting on different keywords, right? No one is going to come here because people are not aware about your website, right? Mostly people are not aware of this particular website. So they are not going to search by this keyword, right? So they are going to search like property in Rajnagar extension, for example. Now the point is getting rank here now. So here you can see, you don't see anything, triple bedroom, no names are coming now. Clear? So yes, I was telling you about the quality of links will also matter, guys. So if you are into sports accessories business and you get a link in educational website, so this website is not much related to sports accessories website. So if this sports accessories website get a link in sports magazine, for example, so that link will really be counted. So this is the quality of the link. Make sense? So if this sports accessories get a link from educational website, that's a good thing that it got a link in educational website, but that is of not that high quality, which is of sportsmagazine.com. Make sense, guys? Quality of links getting clear? Each one of you, please reply. Shivam, Vinu. Yes, okay, great. So guys, so let's say we here we take an example, website A, for example, website B. Then there are three websites. Let's say website A has got 50 links, website B has got 30 links, and website C has got 20 links. Okay, now website C is ranking on one position, website B is ranking on two position, and website A is ranking on three position. How come? Because website C though has got very less number of links, but these links are all of quality links. That's the reason it's ranking on number one, rank one, right? And website two, B has got not that quality links, so it has been ranked on number two. Though website A has got maximum links, guys, which is 50 links they have got, but not of that quality, good quality. So they are on third position, guys. Have you got the concept? Yes, that can happen. Number of links will not matter, guys. Quality of links will matter. Okay, that is about off page. So guys, this is about on page and off page in SEO. And in my next class, we are going to cover on page. We are going to start with the on page. Okay. So today we are going to cover this much only, as time is getting over. And in our next class, we are starting with the on page thing. Okay. In case you guys have any doubt, any query, then please let me know. Shivam, I'll connect with you separately. Yes, I'll connect with you separately tomorrow and let you know. We'll just look into that problem. Yes, next class is on Thursday, Radhika. Same time, same length, you can follow, guys. Okay, and if you guys want to attend tomorrow's class, you are most welcome, guys. Radhika, Shivam. Okay. Sure, Radhika, you can be there. So guys, we are good to wind up for today. Yes. Thank you guys. Thank you so much for your time. And I really appreciate your interactions. Yes, Veenu, please go ahead. Next class is on Thursday, Veenu, same time, 8:30. Same link. Okay. Yes, yes, Veenu, you're right. Tuesday, Thursday, and Saturday, same time. Okay. Okay, guys, thank you so very much for your time today. Let's catch up on Thursday, same time and with the same link, guys. Thank you for today. Bye, guys. Have a good day. Yeah, sure. I'll share the document, Veenu. Have a good night, guys, and take care.